Good afternoon, everyone. Myself Anuraj. My today's topic is forensic firearm examination. So in the field of forensic firearm identification, which is sometimes also called as ballistics, we determine if particular bullet or cartridge case fired from a specific firearm. This determination can be made on the basis of microscopic markings on bullet or cartridge cases that are unique to ammunition fired to that firearm. Firearm identification is the process that deals with analyzing the bullets and the cartridge cases that are left behind at the scene of crime to determine if they came from a particular firearm or not. So for that, we use class and individual characteristics of firearm, which decides if bullet is fired from a suspected firearm. The basis of firearm identification follows the principle of Lockhart's principle of exchange. The surface of the firearm that come in contact with the softer cartridge case and the bullet contain few marks common to a group of firearms and certain unique marks that make it different from other firearms. Thus, class characteristics are characteristics that remain constant to a group of classes, while the individual characteristics are unique to a particular object. So for class characteristics, we can see like there are several general class characteristics associated with the firearm, which are caliber, means a bore diameter of the barrel, or the number of dimension of grooved impressions inside the gun barrel, and the direction of that rifling grooves, like it is either clockwise or anti-clockwise. That grooves are to stabilize the flight path of the bullet. Manufacturers cut spiral grooves into the gun barrel. This pattern of grooves on the barrel leaves corresponding raised and lowered areas on the surface of the bullets fired from it. Measuring the number of that width of this grooves impression can help the firearm examiners to narrow the range of possible weapons. Also, we can see individual characteristics like firing pin marks, breech face marks, ejector marks. Firing pin marks are the when we pull a trigger, a pin-like structure hit the percussion cap of cartridge. This pin-like structure is known as firing pin. In revolvers, it is present on the hammer, and in shotgun rifles, it is on the breech block, and in semi-automatic or automatic guns, it's on the moving breech block. When firing pin hits that percussion cap of cartridge case, it forms a depressed crater-like structure, which is known as firing pin mark. Also, a breech face mark we can see. At the time of firing, there is a burning of the propellant produces gas, which helps in the propulsion of the projectile at the muzzle end. Now, on the other hand, it also pushes the cartridge case towards the breech face. As a result, all imperfections.
Cut off family. Well, that's easy for you to say.
All the imperfections are imprinted on the base of the cartridge case. These marks are known as breech face marks. Now, extractor and ejector marks. In modern firearms, there is an extractor and ejector system for removal of empty cartridges case from the chamber with the help of extractor, and then cartridge case is removed by pulling it towards the backside. After removing the cartridge case from the chamber, there is an ejection of cartridge case with the help of ejector. Generally, there is an absence of ejector system in revolvers. So impurities also present on the surface of extractor and ejector, which imprint striation marks on the surface and remove the cartridge case during the removal of that case. Therefore, comparison microscope, these marks can be compared by size, shape, position, or other individualized characteristics. Also, we can see a chamber marks. Also, for analysis purpose, we use stereo microscopes that are used to determine basic class characteristics. Also, we use mainly comparison microscope to compare the marks on the bullets, cartridge cases. Also, special equipments are used to measure trigger pull of the firearm and examine the interior of the barrel. So there are many facilities such as test fires that submit the firearm and record fire bullets from the cartridge cases. Most laboratories use water recovery method, which uses a large tank of water which poured into which firearm is discharged. There are various database systems like IBs. When we consider firearm and ammunition, it's not just about evidences that we get collect or provide in court, but it's also about information that we have about crimes, firearms, ammunition recovered. So it's very vital intelligence that can help us in order to determine if there are new trends or instances in firearm, either in shootings or manufacturing or trafficking. So fired ammunition components, firearms can come to the lab and entered into the database. This database help us to get information related to the crime, such as type of firearm, manufacturer, model, caliber, serial number, also location, type of ammunition, which will also help and detect the other occurring crimes. Further, this can be linked to the same firearm is whether used in other crimes or not, like that. Also, I'll like to mention one case study, which was linked by ballistic firearm means bullet identification or cases identification. One Gauri Lankesh murder case. On 5th September 2017, three unidentified men shot Gauri to the death at her house in Rajarajeshwari Nagar, Bangalore. Three men fired at least 7 bullets at around 8 p.m. while she was unlocking the main door of her house after returning her office. One of the killers who was waiting her near her house fired the first shot at her, while the two others are suspected to have followed her from the office, joined the initial shooter thereafter. The killer were wearing helmets and escaped the two-wheeler. The three bullets pierced Gauri's head, neck, and chest, resulting her death at the scene. Ballistic reports from Karnataka FSL laboratory stating that Lankesh was killed with the same 7.65 mm country-made gun that was used to kill Kannada scholar M.M. Kalburgi in Dharwad, Karnataka, August 2015. Also, the forensic analysis conducted by Karnataka FSL of bullets and cartridges in Kalburgi case with those recovered from the scene of shooting of leftist thinker Govind Pansare and his wife on 16 February 2015 at Kolhapur showed that one of two 7.6 mm country-made guns were used in both the cases. And the ballistic reports also said that the second 7.65 mm gun used in Pansare murder was also used to kill the rationalist Narendra Dabholkar in Pune, August 2013. Like in this way, we can link the crimes by analyzing the bullets or cartridge case marks, etc. Thank you.